Oh, I've been nervous about that bit, getting the sword get discombobulated. Don't touch yourself, all right? Hello. Hello. Shame beneath for this. My main boo is bipolar. Although, let me tell you this. During lockdown, when everyone was wearing the masks, I was like, what the dickens is everyone saying? Turned out, deaf. Been deaf my whole life. I had no idea, and I've been lip reading. Hearing aids, and I thought I now know what everyone's saying. Still don't have a clue. People don't enunciate, and people are always lurking in the darkness. But I can now hear nature very loudly. So I still can't have a chat with you, but I can hear a group of squirrels planning a robbery from about 10 miles away, and they've got drones. Yeah, boy, Paula, I once went on a date with this guy, which always comes as a surprise that I'm a fan of the sausage. And I have my medication in my bum bag because Blay is going to play. And hello. And he goes, "What's that?" And I'm quite an open book, so I said, "Oh, that's my bipolar medication. I got bipolar." And he goes, "Oh, bipolar? Does that mean you're going to murder me in the night?" Well, it didn't mean that. And then my driving instructor, he says that he thought I either have ADHD or dyspraxia, but batten down the hatches, I got enough to be dealing with. My first lesson, I went round the roundabout the wrong way round, and my driving instructor was very upset. I said, I said, calm your cockles, Kenny. If you think about it, if you're supposed to go round the roundabout in a precise fashion, surely it'd be called an around exactly. I'm just going about. one test was aborted. What happened was the examinator. Basically, every time I did something wrong, she kept tutting. There was a lot of tutting. After a while, I was like, "All right, tutting Carmoon, we get the picture." And then what happened was it started raining. I put the wind. Well, I never had a lesson in the rain, you see. Sounds old. I hadn't. So I put the windscreen wipers on eventually. And then. And then she just suddenly goes, "Please pull over in a safe place." And I was like, "Nowhere's safe." And then eventually, when I pulled over, apparently what had happened was when I put the windscreen wipers on, apparently I started going. That's dangerous, you see. I think particularly dangerous because I've got such a long neck. I got a neck like a swan. And I know I've got a neck like a swan because once I was cutting across a park as a shortcut and a swan followed me. And I think because it was trying to mate with me for life. I knew this girl in Cornwall that got her kids taken away from her because she left them with a group of swans. But I think if you can't trust something that was protected by the Queen to look after your kids, who can you trust? Hello. I said it in court and I'd say it again. And my final nightmare is
is this your card?
My final blabber is middle. This is me trying to be relatable, you see. Middle lane hoggers. Middle lane hoggers. Driving along, say I'm driving along this way, and then middle lane hogger, not a bother. I will just overtake, and then what annoys me is then when you go to overtake, and then they speed up, and it's like, well, I'm only overtaking you because you're going so dripping slow. So what I do when that happens is I go full throttle, pedal to the metal, and then whiz past them, and then as I'm going past them, I look at them, and I go... But that's dangerous, you see, because I'm driving that way, I'm looking that way. It's dangerous, dangerous, danger! So this is what I do. You can have this.
This is what I drive along. I just...
100 of these. And they said, when I got printed, they said, oh, we've never had anyone asked to keep the eyes in. In the next batch, I'll have them out, and then no one has business cards anymore. So I reckon I'll just pass them to people like that. So it looks like I'm handing them my wink. I think this has been an experience for all involved. Genuinely, thanks so much. All the best in your endeavours. Cheers.